Hi guys, welcome to AI Probably again, and this is Archit Agarwal. Now we are in our final part of our Django course, that is Django deployment. In this particular part, we'll be seeing how to launch our app on some hosting platforms like Heroku or GitHub, and we'll be going in depth as how to host your Django app on Heroku, and yeah, that will bring us to the end of this particular part. So let's get started and see how we can host our app on Heroku. So now we'll be going to Django deployment. We have successfully deployed a machine learning model using Django, and we have also created a cool web application for the same, but the app is still accessible by the local machine only. To make it go live, we can host this on any of the hosting platforms like Heroku, GitHub, and etc. So let's see how we can host our app on Heroku for free. So the first thing is we need to sign up to Heroku and then install the Heroku CLI, which is Heroku command line interface, and it is a tool to manage your Heroku apps. After that, we need to log into Heroku using Heroku login, and it will ask you for your credentials. After typing your email and password, you will be logged in to Heroku. After that, we need to make our project ready for deployment on Heroku. To do that, we need to first create a file named proc file without any extensions, and it will be having this particular line here. So it will say web colon gunicorn model api dot wsgi. So instead of model api, you guys should provide the name of your project, of your Django project. After that, we need to create a requirements.txt file. So to create that, you can just use pip freeze arrow requirements.txt to create it automatically, or you can just write it manually, which only has the name of the libraries and the packages which are used to run the particular application. In the end, your requirements.txt file should look like this. So it has the name of the libraries which will be used to run the particular app. And after that, we need to make some changes in the settings.py file. So first we need to import Django Heroku in the settings.py file, and in the end of the settings.py file, we need to add django-heroku.settings locals. What it does is it loads the local settings on the Heroku. After that, we just need to put these commands. Like first we need to create the Heroku project, which is Titanic Predictor Web. And after that, we need to initialize the GitHub repository in it. And then we need to add Heroku Git Remote Titanic Predictor Web. So this Titanic Predictor Web is just the name of the application you want to give it to your app. So if you want your app to be, or if you want the URL to your app to be titanicpredictorweb.herokuapp.com, you just provide that name here, or say xyz.herokuapp.com. So then you write Heroku create xyz. After that, we'll be using git add dot, so it will add all the files. Then we'll be committing it, and after that we'll be pushing it using git push Heroku master. So after the push is successful, you can easily access your application using this particular link, which is titanicpredictorweb.herokuapp.com, and that is the same URL which we have been using here. So okay, we can see that the app is successfully deployed. Now we have reached to the end of the course, and in this course we saw how to deploy machine learning models using Django. We created an API for that, and we used that created API in our Streamlit web application. Just remember, you can use it in any other application like Android, iOS, or anywhere else. Then we created a web app using Django. We understood about the project and the app structure of Django. We understood about the MVT pattern of the Django, and we deployed the app using Heroku. So congratulations, you have achieved all this knowledge. And I hope you liked this particular session. But before just wrapping it up, I just need to tell you what more you can do. So just now we touched on the MVT pattern. We saw the Django elements like URLs, paths, and all. But there are still few things which we did not cover. So the web application which I just now made was purely HTML. You can also include JavaScript and CSS in your applications. In the Django applications, you can also use the database as Postgres SQL. Then you can also create Node.js servers. You can have Gunicorn. You can use Flask alongside. And the rest all is just your imagination. Like whatever you want to do, you need to search for it and you need to see how you can do it. But this was a basic course. This was just to make you prepare for the Django and how to start with Django actually. So thank you guys. And if you guys have any questions or suggestions, please feel free to comment down below and we'll be replying to your questions as soon as we can. So thank you again. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subs would be nice, and please hit the bell icon to get the latest updates from probably.